Associate Zoning Administrator for the Office of Zoning Administration for the Conditional Compliance Uses Abatement Revocation Unit. In reference to case number DIR 2016-0824 RV Revocation Discontinuance of Use for Project Address at 6360 through 6366 West Hollywood Boulevard, also including address number 1646 North Cosmo Street in Hollywood Planning Area. On Tuesday, May 10th, 2016, a public hearing was held in City Hall Room 1070 to discuss the possible imposition of conditions to abate nuisance or revocation use for the operation known as Cosmo Nightclub, located at, again, 6364 West Hollywood Boulevard in the Hollywood Community Plan Area. To highlight a few of the frequently violated CUP conditions as noted on the notice of public hearing, I'd like to note that there was a failure of security guards to wear distinctive uniforms, a failure to utilize electronic age verification devices, subletting of the premises to outside promoters, improper notification to the Los Angeles Police Department of private parties, failure to adhere to mandated closing time, allowance of amplified music to extend beyond the premises. In addition, the multiple criminal and nuisance activities occurred on the site, which included a discharge of a firearm in the city, assault with a deadly weapon, aggravated assault, narcotic drug violation, sale of alcohol to an obviously intoxicated person, presence of a minor inside the premises in possession of alcohol beverages, public nuisance, public intoxication, theft, vandalism, and noise disturbance. A conditional use permit is currently in effect at the site and location under case number CA 2013-0832-CUB-CUX, which permits the continued sale and use of a full line of alcohol beverages for on-site consumption in conjunction with an existing cocktails bar / lounge, and to permit the continuation of public dancing. The grant entitlement is for a 3-year period of time, which was effective September 3rd, 2013, and will expire September 3rd, 2016. At which time the grant will then be required, the applicant will then be required to file or seek the authorization or the approval of a new sale of alcohol and beverages on site and also for dancing. Prior to the public hearing on Thursday, March 17th, 2016, between the hours of 9:30 p.m. and 11 p.m., planning staff accompanied by approximately 5 Los Angeles Police Department officers conducted a field analysis as part of this nuisance investigation. The operation was found in partial but not full compliance of the 2013 conditions as stated. At the time of the site visit, there were at least 5 patrons in the establishment. The manager noted to staff that normally there would be, at any time, it would be between 10 and 15 people who would be seated at a total of 12 tables. Violation of CUP confirmed during the field investigation are as follows. Condition number 14, the club manager stated that there had not been any advertisement for the disc jockey. However, the Cosmo website and social media pages did advertise DJ Entertainment. And the date stated is April 22nd, 2016, as noted in the staff report. Condition number 18, the establishment was open for the public and there was no security guards present at the time of the site visit. The manager said that they were on break and one had not yet arrived. The club manager said the guards usually start their shifts at 9:50 p.m. Condition number 18 requires that a minimum of 2 state licensed security uniform guards be present between the days of Sunday through Thursday and a minimum of 3 security guards on Friday and Saturday. Guards shall begin their duties a minimum of 30 minutes prior to the opening of the facility and remain 30 minutes after closing. Condition number 22, the club had an age verification device, which the club manager says security / personnel use at the door when patrons come in. The age verification device was not working at the time of the site visit. The manager had a backup age verification device on a smartphone that was operational. Noted that condition number 22 requires that the electronic age verification device be installed on the premises and at each point of sale location, and that the employees be made knowledgeable of the operation of such devices. Condition number 27, club manager was unable to produce proof of star training at the time of the site visit. However, he provided proof in the form of a letter submitted by email on March 23rd of 2016. Condition number 31, the name of the on-duty manager, at this time it was Matthew Goldsberg, was listed in, that the name listed of the manager in a conspicuous place near the entrance of the business for view. However, the hotline number listed revealed that the main number of the club with a recorded message allowed interested parties to leave a message. Condition number 31 requires that the phone number be served as a hotline number for contact regarding any complaints of the facility operation. The crime department has received multiple arrest records, crime analysis documentation, and calls of service reports for the subject site from the Los Angeles Police Department, covering a time period of January 9, 2014 to April 25, 2016. Reports received from the Los Angeles Police Department from the operation known as the Cosmo Nightclub indicated that there were 24 arrests and investigation reports which were submitted for the property and near the property between the dates of January 7, 2015 and April 25, 2016. 19 arrest charges submitted to the property between January 9, 2014 and February 27, 2016. 12 crime charges submitted to the for the property between October 9, 2014 and March 10, 2016. 19 calls for service submitted for the property between May 28, 2014 and March 10, 2016. Of the 24 arrest and investigative reports submitted to the property and over a 15-month period of time between January 1st, 2015 and April 25th, 2016, the property owner operator were cited for multiple violations of the CUP case number CA-2013-0832, CUB-CUX. The most frequent condition violations occurring on the property are as follows. Condition number 12, the facility leased or rented out to promoters. Condition number 17, cover charge or prepayment for admission to premises. Condition number 18, security guards not state licensed and not uniformed. Condition number 21, music, sound, or noise was audible beyond the subject site. As well as the violations of condition number 7, overcrowding. Maximum occupancy was not to exceed 130 persons. Condition number 22, use of an electronic age verification device, which also can be used to determine the age of any individual attempting to purchase alcohol beverages. Condition number 23, CUP approved of conditions shall be retained on the property at all times and produced upon request of the zoning administrator, police department, and building and safety. A copy of said conditions shall be provided to all employees who shall sign and acknowledge the form. Form shall be maintained at the location. Violations also include condition number 26, the applicant owner and or site manager shall comply with all applicable laws and conditions and said properly manage the facility to discourage illegal and criminal activity on the subject premises. Condition number 27, all employees involved with the sale of alcohol beverages shall enroll in the Los Angeles Police Department standardized training for alcohol retailers for the STAR program. Condition number 31, name of on-duty manager shall be listed in a conspicuous place near entrance of building. The phone number shall also serve as a hotline to register any complaints of the facility's operation. Condition number 8, hours of operation shall not exceed 6 p.m. to 2 a.m. daily. Condition number 9, no after hours use of the facility shall be permitted. Condition number 14, a disc jockey is permitted in the mezzanine area. There shall be no public advertising for any disc jockey entertainment at this facility. And condition number 10, the premises shall not be exclusively used for private parties, including promotional events, of which the general public is excluded. The premises may be used up to a maximum of 12 times per calendar year for the private events. As presented in this information, documented through correspondence and public testimony by affected parties, it was determined that the operation of the nightclub known as Cosmo has created a public nuisance and impact at the site. Findings were made in the affirmative that the operation jeopardized and adversely affected the health, peace, and safety of persons working and residing in the surrounding areas. Condition number 36 placed on, there were 36 conditions placed on the operation per ZA case 2013-0832 CUBCUX. And they were put in place to preserve the health, peace, and safety of the persons working and residing in the surrounding area. The public record, including arrest reports and testimony at the public hearing, indicated that there had been documented ongoing violations of these conditions, in addition to the violation of state of California ABC license. Serious and violent criminal activities have taken place at the site and at the location adjacent to the site, involving patrons and staff of the Cosmo nightclub. These activities appear to be increasingly frequent over the past year. Findings were also made to constitute a public nuisance. There are considerable impacts from the use of this site, which the surrounding neighborhood. These include assaults, discharge of firearms, lack of compliance with the conditional use permit and the state of California liquor license. Most evident was the public nuisance is the noise services originating from the location and threats to public safety from the history of the violent crimes that have taken place at the site. The neighboring business, known as IOS Club, testified at the public hearing as to the financial impacts that they have experienced with a decrease in bookings and attendance from which they believe are directly associated with the negative role played by the Cosmo nightclub. The use has generated a considerable amount of required resources from the Los Angeles Police Department. The need for continued investigation has been a drain on the department's resources. Findings were also made resulting in reported nuisance activities. As noted earlier, the Los Angeles Police Department has documented numerous and ongoing violations of the conditions imposed by the zoning administrator under said case CA 2013-0832 CUBCUX, including noise off-pro beyond the premises, security guards not having state license and not wearing distinctive uniforms, lack of star training, lack of notification to the Hollywood Vice of private parties, admission being charged to enter the premises and the facility being leased to outside promoters. Violation provisions of this chapter, findings were also made regarding the violated provisions of this chapter, the Los Angeles Municipal Code, Administrative Nuisance Abatement Proceedings, and other city, state, and federal regulations, ordinances, and statutes. The record includes a detailed account of the Los Angeles Police Department investigations and arrests concerning the Cosmo nightclub, including violations of conditions imposed by both the city and state of California Alcohol Beverage Control. In addition, arrests of Cosmo business owners, management, and employees have been shown to include possessions of narcotics, allowing a minor inside the premises, service of an overly intoxicated person, failure to have a valid security guard card, certification of outstanding warrants. Findings were also made that prior governmental efforts to cause the owner operator to eliminate the problems associated with the use or discretionary zoning approval have failed. The Cosmo nightclub has placed a heavy demand on limited Los Angeles Police Department resources and has resulted in over 20 separate arrests and investigative incidents since December 13, 2015. The governmental efforts to cause the owner-operator to eliminate the nuisance problems associated with the use and to achieve conditions compliance have failed, as documented by the excessive and repeated number of arrests, investigations, and calls for service by the Los Angeles Police Department. Many of the documented violations are repeated violations which have occurred over a short period of time. There have been no discernible improvements of the operation. Subsequent to the repeated action of the police department, conducting investigations and making arrests at the site, there has been no demonstrable effort to correct or address any of the violations identified. The business operator and the management of the Cosmo have been given numerous opportunities to demonstrate an attempt to comply with the conditions and address the issues of public nuisance at the site. In addition, findings were made that the owner-operator has failed to demonstrate the willingness or ability to eliminate the problems associated with the use of the discretionary zoning approval. The current business manager and the legal representative of the business owner attended the public hearing date May 10, 2016. Many of the crimes submitted in testimony which had taken place at the location were denied. Also, many of the CPA violations were also denied. In some testimony, there was acknowledgement of connection of the Cosmo nightclub to nuisance activities originating from the site. However, the seriousness of such activities was dismissed or downplayed, as indicated by the February 26, 2016 incident in which a former patron of the Cosmo had attacked the business manager and was subsequently attacked by the Cosmo staff, resulting in an 8-inch laceration to the chest and one member of the Cosmo staff intentionally struck by a car, all taking place on a city street adjacent to the club. The incident was described as a small altercation. The business operator and the management have continued to take no responsibility for most of the public nuisances originating from the location, including most of the CUP violations. No constructive measures to alleviate the public nuisance associated with the site were proposed by the property owner, operator, or employee. Therefore, there continues to be no demonstrable effort to prevent or address the violations and public nuisance at the location by the property owner, business management, or employees. The zoning administrator found that the repeated administrative attempts to approve the operation of the cocktail bar slash lounge with the associated alcohol use has not resulted in the elimination of problems associated with the use, and therefore ordered the discontinuance of the operation known as the Cosmo. In this case, again, the business owner and operator have had multiple opportunities to address the allegations and documented reports of nuisance allegations occurring on the site or adjacent to the site, and failed to respond or eliminate said nuisance activities. Again, as the zoning administrator acting in a quasi-judicial capacity, the authority is given should findings be made to revoke a permit lawfully granted. Due process requires a notice be given to the permittee upon which a hearing was issued or noticed and mailed properly to the property owner, business owner, and the property address. And upon evidence, also substantially finding and supporting a revocation action, which was received through the Los Angeles Department of Police Department, from arrest reports, analysis, crime data analysis, and calls for service to the property location. The business owner or property owner has renovated the property and proceeded in good faith based upon permits received, also including a conditional use permit and the 36 operating conditions. Staff therefore recommends that the council uphold the zoning administrator's action and deny the appeal.
Thank you for that. Any questions for staff? Questions at this point? Yeah, we might have another PD. That fine. Here from another PD. And the appellants. And a comment. Carrie Packer from Police Department, Officer Benjamin Thompson, afterwards, and Detective Dana Harris. Welcome.
Good afternoon. I'm Corey Packer, the Area Commanding Officer of Hollywood Division. So I had lunch today with a developer named Kathleen Marabi, who owns several real estate buildings in San Fernando Valley. And he's considering investing in Hollywood, a multi-million dollar investor. His concern, like most of the investors who come into Hollywood, is public safety. And I assure him through public safety that we can help him develop and prosper as he invests in Hollywood. In order to continue and sustain public safety and to continue economic growth in Hollywood, we need compliant partners. We need business partners who will meet with us, who will greet us, and listen to what we know as being true to operate successfully a business in an entertainment venue. This client, the Cosmo, has not done that. We have repeatedly tried to partner with them, give them the opportunity to be successful so we can grow the economy, so people can invest in Hollywood. And the reality is, when I look at my anchor points in Hollywood, we draw a circle around the intersection where the Cosmo is at, and I can show you repeat violent crime in and around that neighborhood, because of their failed compliance, their unwillingness to be a good partner. I need to continue the economic growth in Hollywood with good partners and good investors. And the Cosmo just has not been one. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, council members. I'm Officer Benjamin Thompson, serial number 39467. I'm here today representing the Los Angeles Police Department on an appeal matter that is before you. I'm a vice investigator for the department and I'm currently assigned to the Hollywood area vice unit. I've been investigating vice conditions and providing regulatory oversight of various alcoholic beverage retail establishments that operate in the Hollywood area for over 2 years. I've had extensive experience with the Cosmo operation and I'm one of the lead investigators of a comprehensive and long-term investigation related to crime misuse of the retail premises. Hollywood Vice investigators have been negotiating inspections of the Cosmo premises for over a year now. These compliance inspections were precipitated by a series of community complaints regarding nuisance activity associated with the venue and pursuant to the increase in the occurrence of violent crimes immediately around and inside the subject premises. Early inspections of the operation substantiated the reported Cosmo nuisance activity, and early research indicated that this nuisance activity was a contributing factor in the overall amplification of criminal activity in the Hollywood Entertainment District. During initial site examinations, officers encountered conspicuous and seemingly blatant operational deviations that motivated further scrutiny as investigators were compelled to repeatedly examine the premises for the purposes of inducing operational compliance and mitigating negative impact. Over the course of this investigative period, investigators found that the Cosmo business was in consistent violation of the following conditional use permit conditions. Condition number 17, which states there shall be no cover charge or prepayment required for admission to the premises. Conditional use permit condition number 18, which pertains to security guard licensing and uniform requirements. Conditional use permit condition number 21, which prohibits the operator from allowing music to extend beyond the subject premises. Conditional use permit number 10, requires that the operator not use the premises exclusively for private parties and provide a 7-day notification to the Hollywood area vice unit prior to using the property for a private event. Conditional use permit number 12 mandates that the facility shall not be leased or rented out to promoters at any time. The operator shall at all times retain operational control of the premises and utilize only the facility's regular employees, own security staffs, and bartenders for any event. Repeated inspection of the Cosmo venue has revealed that all these individual conditional use permit conditions are routinely disregarded by the establishment operator and the operator's agents. The Cosmo conditional use permit is comprised of 36 operating conditions regulating and restricting use of the property the establishment is connected with. The 36 conditions essentially consist of operational requirements that were imposed to ensure the vote and character of the establishment remains consistent with the cocktail lounge and bar that it was proposed to be when the grant was issued. These conditions additionally serve to mitigate nuisance impacts from use of the facility and provide an operational framework to enhance public safety. The Cosmo function is not directly and individually regulated by the conditional use permit, but also by the California state-issued alcoholic beverage control license, which authorizes the operator to distribute alcoholic beverages in a commercial capacity. The Cosmo alcoholic beverage control license contains 19 operational conditions regulating exercise of the license privilege. The majority of the alcoholic beverage control license conditions resemble the conditions delineated in the Cosmo conditional use permit and restricts use of the premises in similar fashion. Similar to the style in which the Cosmo operation is routinely found to be negotiating business in violation of the governing conditional use permit, the venue operation is often functioning in concurrent violation of the associated alcoholic beverage control license. Since January 7th of 2015, which marks the date that Hollywood Vice Unit began to perform inspections of the Cosmo facility with regularity, investigators have repeatedly observed that the Cosmo establishment is consistent violation of alcoholic beverage control license conditions 2, 6, 17, and number 18. Number 2 prohibits the operator from mandating or requiring a admission charge or cover fee. Alcoholic beverage license condition number 6 mandates that sale and delivery of alcoholic beverages to customers shall be made from behind a counter where a clerk will obtain the product. No self-service of alcoholic beverages will be permitted. Alcoholic beverage control license condition number 17 specifies that entertainment provided shall not be audible beyond the area under the control of the licensee. And alcoholic beverage control license condition number 19 requires security guards to be licensed and uniformed in a readily identifiable fashion. From January 7, 2015 up to the present, Hollywood Vice investigators have inspected the Cosmo premises on 27 separate occasions. In 23 of those inspections, investigators took enforcement actions against the Cosmo operators and management staff for violations of municipal code ordinances and state laws that regulate commercial function. During this time period, Hollywood Vice investigators observed the Cosmo premises to be operated in violation of conditional use permit condition number 17 on 12 different occasions, with 3 of those instances occurring after May 26, 2016, when the revocation of use decision was announced. Investigators observed the premises to be operated in violation of conditional use permit number 18 on 10 different occasions, with 2 of those instances occurring following the revocation decision. Investigators observed the establishment to be operated in violation of conditional use permit condition number 21 on 6 different occasions, with 1 of those instances occurring following the May 26 revocation of use decision. Over the course of this entire investigative period, investigators have found the Cosmo premises to be operated in violation of conditional use permit number 10 on 3 separate occasions, conditional use permit number 12 on 2 separate occasions, conditional use permit number 22 on 2 separate occasions. During the involved 27 site inspections, investigators also observed the premises to be operated in violation of alcoholic beverage control license condition number 2 on 4 separate instances, with 2 of those transpiring after the revocation of use determination was issued of alcoholic beverage control license condition number 6, with 3 separate instances, with 1 of those occasions transpiring after the revocation of use decision was issued of alcoholic beverage control license condition number 17 on 4 separate occasions, with 1 of those instances transpiring after the revocation of use decision was issued, and of alcoholic beverage control license condition number 19 on 3 separate occasions, with 1 of those instances identifying after the revocation decision was issued. Over the course of Hollywood Vice's scrutiny of the Cosmo operations, investigators have found the facility to be operated in violation of numerous other regulatory statutes aside from the conditional use permit and alcoholic beverage control license operating conditions. On 2 separate investigative occasions, Vice investigators discovered Cosmo management staff to be allowing patrons of minority to enter and remain in the Type 48 licensed premises in violation of Business and Professions Code Section 25665 and took enforcement action as a result of the discovery. During 3 different site examinations, investigators arrested establishment security guards after finding that the involved employees were unlicensed by the Bureau of Security and Investigative Services in violation of Business and Professions Code Section 16240. The most recent of these security guard arrests was effected on July 22nd, well after the revocation of use decision was rendered. Investigators have also arrested Cosmo security guard employees on 2 separate occasions for outstanding misdemeanor arrest warrants and have arrested establishment manager for employing proprietary security employees without having obtained a California state license or endorsement to do so, in violation of Business and Professions Code Section 7574.12. During 1 previous inspection, investigators arrested an establishment bartender for a violation of Business and Professions Code Section 25602, subsection A, providing alcoholic beverage service to an obviously intoxicated person. While engaged in another prior inspection of the venue, investigators arrested an establishment manager for a violation of Health and Safety Code Section 11350, Subsection A, possession of a controlled substance. And while negotiating another recent examination of the premises, investigators arrested an establishment patron for selling an undercover vice officer narcotics in violation of Health and Safety Code Section 11352, Subsection A. My investigation of the Cosmo operation thus far has revealed that the operator has operated and continues to operate the Cosmo venue in willful and blatant disregard of the legal requirements imposed on the business function and use by the City of Los Angeles and the State of California. Outreach attempts and traditional enforcement methods have proven to be ineffective in this case, and it appears that the operator is intent on conducting business in violation of the regulations that the operator initially agreed to adhere to, and at the risk of legal repercussion and detriment to public safety. For the foregoing reasons, the Los Angeles Police Department respectfully requests that you affirm the revocation of use determination that was rendered by Zoning Administrator Alita James on May 26, 2016. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Any questions? Detective Harris, welcome.
Good afternoon. In the interest of time, I'll be brief with my comments. As the officer in charge of the Detective Support and Vice Division of the Bay Area, I have known or I've seen this club just be in constant violation of not only the alcohol beverage control, the calls for service, nuisance related crime, but what I'm most concerned about is the crime of violence which are occurring. The sexual assault, the stabbing, the assault with a deadly weapon, and just as important, the two separate driving for under the influence of alcohol after the Club Cosmo. Again, I agree with my co-workers and I would ask that you look.
Can you hold your testimony, please? Just as a general policy, we ask those who are filming in here, you can not use the bright flash or lights. If we have a few of those, it kind of disrupts public speakers and others from speaking. Thank you.
Okay, in closing, I would ask that you uphold this revocation. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So we have two appellants. We will go first to one set of appellants and their representatives. Michael Ayaz, Rick Lake, Michael Colazzi.
Councilmember, I believe one of the appellants withdrew their appeal. There's a letter regarding the appeal filed by maybe Ballour and Palmer Building Associates indicating that the appellant has decided to withdraw that appeal.
Okay, so is that the same with Sean?
No.
That's the same part, that's the same, that's the same appeal, right? Sean's with you. Okay. Typically, we have appellants give them an opportunity of 5 minutes to present their case. Here, you have the opportunity also to submit individual cards for public comment. So you have three here. You could have 5 minutes plus 1 minute for each, which is general public comments. So you could have a total of 7 minutes, which is up to you. 7 minutes for the three.
Well, before those 7 minutes starts, I'd like to object to that on the record. We've just given the city about 15 to 20 minutes to present their case. Given the gravity and the complexity of the case, giving us 5 to 7 minutes to make our case is yet
another. Okay, sir, thank you. Unfortunately, we will have to start your time, and you can state that on the record when you begin your time. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, then we will take the 7 minutes. Perhaps 6 minutes will be fine. Again, I object to the process that in which we are not allowed the equal opportunity to defend ourselves. Obviously, you've given the police and the planning department plenty of time to present the case, and it's just another indication that this body is not an independent hearing body. We're not giving the due process that we deserve. We submitted a brief to the council. I hope that you've read it, or I certainly hope that you do read it before you render a decision. I think given our time limitation, it's imperative that you do that because it sets forth a lot of things that we're not going to be able to get to today.
First and foremost, my client was denied due process, and we still live in America, and the Constitution of the United States and California Constitution still apply. And during the initial hearing, and we heard testimony from the hearing officer with new facts that were never presented to you, presented to us before, let alone at the CA hearing, but here today, we asked for a postponement so that we could adequately prepare, only having been retained 6 days prior. We were summarily denied that. This hearing officer allowed testimony into the hearing record that you folks will review that we were not provided in advance so that we could adequately prepare and get by the interview process. Our equal protection for also violated, and that the CA is merely carrying out the edict of the city council members, the particular city council member, the LAPD, the CCU, and other agencies within the city. There is an element of race that's in this that we have a video that we'd like to show, but we've been basically told that might not happen, where the bid, a committee that is sanctioned by the city talks about too many blacks, browns, and people of lower income strata coming to these clubs into Hollywood, and wanting to have the Lindsay Lohans of the world coming to this place, and she's by no means any queen of responsibility. The hearing officer was biased, which was apparent from the very get-go. She is apparently a member of the planning staff. There was no safeguards between the zoning hearing office and the planning and the CCU. She's supposed to be a judicial officer and have an independent review of this, but that is by far not happening here. She is part of the process and the clandestine effort from wherever this is coming from to eradicate these types of businesses. She has to be an independent hearing officer, and her testimony today and her actions show that she's not an independent hearing officer. This applicant has been condemned before convicted. You heard them repeat and repeat and repeat crimes that have never been adjudicated. There's been not one case that has gone to court and a judge of competent jurisdiction or a real judge has not found our client guilty of one single thing. The ABC has not cited my client for one single thing. The Los Angeles Police Department has no jurisdiction to talk to me about things about alcoholic beverages because the ABC has its own peace officers that do that. And again, though that agency, the state agency that actually has a separate judicial officer review, has never even cited my client. That there is an incestual relationship between all of these parties that are here before you, with the most of the shocking should be the zoning administrator. They're supposed to be independent of the planning, the Department of City Planning, the CCU. How can that be when the CCU hearing, the CCU officers also act as CAs, which we've also included in our original, we've also stated in our original record. The ZA could not have reached the required findings to revoke this permit. The police department has made no effort to make outreach to us. They have not provided a single email, letter, anything to you folks that can establish the fact that they've actually made attempts to meet with us. What they've done is, instead of going through the normal plan approval process, and in fact, in our brief, you'll see an exhibit that's an attachment from Coletta James, who used to be a planner and now is a CA, where she sets forth the nuisance abatement process. And before you get to the ultimate revocation, which is essentially a death sentence for my client, you have to go through certain steps. And those certain steps are codified in 1227.1. They have to go in for a plan approval. They have to give these people some kind of bureaucratic option to remedy the situations. They went straight for revocation. They went straight for the throne. Because we know the reason that they did this intentionally is because there is an hit list for certain clubs in Hollywood, and this hit list, we don't know how we get on this hit list. We don't know who the king is of Los Angeles that's putting people on this hit list, but it does exist. And when this matter proceeds, if it has to, we will find out. Again, the city has to allow for the plan approval, or at least a bureaucratic option for something, instead of going straight for revocation. You're talking about taking a person's right away, a constitutional right of millions and millions of dollars that they've invested in this property. There is no nexus, or they made no attempt to show a connection between what happens with an open container down the street, or a shooting that may have happened six blocks away, or something that happens at one of the other five or four clubs that are in the same exact building. You cannot pin all of these things on this client. There has to be a nexus. The Constitution requires there to be a nexus before you take away someone's constitutional right. None of the claims, and again, as they said, we will take credit where credit is due when we do stuff wrong, but not to the degree where we just come in and take away the business without making any efforts to talk to us, and then, on top of it, assign the crimes that happen outside of the premises to our client. This is Hollywood Boulevard. This is a busy entertainment district. This is not a very quiet area. And to say it's noisy on Hollywood Boulevard is almost laughable. The criminal judge laughed at these tickets, and the attorney handling that will talk about that. There's a bid video, and that's what we intend to show in one of our follow-up videos, where the bid is talking about no blacks, no browns, and people of lower income strata should not be coming to Hollywood. Is that the legacy that this committee wants to have? Instead of working with people, instead of lying about working with people, make them work with us and let us save our business. There's employees, there's taxes, there's many things that are happening here. There's also in their staff report some connection with Cashmere, and that is wholly inappropriate. These are two separate entities, and we cannot be guilty by association. That is incomplete. It's just frustrating. It can't be done this way. We do not live in a communist country where this can happen, and thank goodness we have a court system that at least we have to rely on. We don't know what the impetus of this is. We have our suspicions, but these are certainly not driven by neighbor complaints. These are not resident complaints. You have one neighbor that's entering testimony, and in that testimony, it's very telling. 16 bullet holes in my wall, but there's no police reports that go to that. Plus, she's not a neighbor. If there were 16 bullet holes, why aren't there reports for that? Why didn't those people make any kind of claims? There's no resident complaints. These are driven and acting as a henchman for other agencies within the city. There's an element of race that's here that you must hear. These people are here to do that. They're targeting black clubs and clubs that cater to black and brown and people of lower income strata, as the video will show. We have dozens of examples of white clubs that do the same thing and worse, except they sit on the bid and they don't get the same kind of treatment we do. It's an evolution of racism, ladies and gentlemen. They're not beating you anymore. They're taking your businesses away. Next, it's going to be your barbershops. It's going to be your restaurants. It's going to be your stores.
Sir, I've got your time is up.
Thank you.
Sean Rafahite. And after Sean is, I buried him. The public comment card was a card by an LAPD officer. Abim Munoz, you can speak after Mr. Rafahite. Karen, please. You so wish to still speak. And as is protocol and policy in this committee, the appellants have 5 minutes, all of the public speakers have 1 minute, so you will have 1 minute, sir. Sean Rafahite.
Raphael, thank you. Sean Raphael from Cosmo, I'm going to attempt to play the short clip as referenced earlier by Mr. Young. I'm going to try to do that now.
Hollywood Division, the Hollywood Vice Unit, and the stakeholders for our community that are affected by the Cosmo nightclub. I'm speaking on behalf of the residents, the business neighbors, tourists, visitors, and the law enforcement officers who are allocated to patrol and protect the persons around this establishment on a nightly basis. It is my expert opinion that the discontinuance of the operation of the Cosmo nightclub and that the denial of the conditional use permit is undeniably crucial based on the club's past history, which has included violent assaults, shootings outside of the club, and the unreliable management and security personnel which have been subject of the numerous warnings, citations, and physical arrests.
effective partnership between Los Angeles Police Department and the community stakeholders like the Cosmo Nightclub is essential to public safety, as we've heard. Regrettably, it is evident that despite repeated efforts to meet with the operators through available community police advisory board meetings and one-on-one consultations, that the Cosmo operators are unwilling to engage with the police department in any part, and to engage with the police department in any type of cooperative effort aimed at improving business practice and enhancing public safety. Due to the impasse and lack of cooperation, the Los Angeles Police Department has been required to commit a vast amount of resources to provide security for both the Cosmo patrons and the Hollywood Entertainment District. Hollywood Vision has been obligated to detach patrol units on a regular basis to mitigate nuisance impact generated from the venue, and my office has been required to spend hundreds of hours in the pursuit of provoking legal compliance and operational responsibility with this club. The Cosmo operation has established itself as a massive burden to the Hollywood area community. The Los Angeles Police Department has been consistently forced to allocate resources to manage the crime that occurs as a result of the operation, thereby rendering other areas of the city and community unsecured and susceptible to crime and disorder. The drain of the resources that the Cosmo currently demands, coupled with the violent crimes that have been occurring with increasing frequency in relation to the venue and the blatant and seemingly willful disregard of the legal requirements that regulate the use of the facilities, serve to represent the reasons for why the discontinuance of use decisions is a public safety necessity. I, along with the officers under my command, request that you uphold the revocation of use determination that was issued following the May 10th public hearing. Thank you.
Thank you. Remy Garanova. Mary Ann Sweet Smith. Christina Williams. Can you hear me speak? Oh, okay, here. Remy, calling once, calling twice. Okay, you have 1 minute. Mary Ann Smith and Christina Williams. Welcome. Each person has 1 minute. Right here. Good line up after the other person. Welcome.
Hi, good afternoon. So my name is Moses Hill, and I'm a campaign manager for a publicity firm with Echoing Sounds. Moses Hill.
Moses, yeah. You haven't called
me. I'm in place of the record.
You have to fill out a new card, sir, and then we don't allow that. So if you can just fill out a new card, we'll get your name on the card and the rest of the record. So if you can talk to her. Right here, yeah. Thank you. So you, okay, so Remy here, no?
We have one more
left. Mary Ann Smith? Okay, welcome. We have your card here. You can speak, Mary Ann. Are you Mary Ann Smith? Okay, go ahead, go right ahead.
Well, I'm here in representation of the nightclub. I've been there personally. All my experiences have been very positive. It's a place that I have frequented before, and I felt safe, especially as a young woman in Hollywood. I'm always very concerned about my well-being, and I've never felt unsafe. I haven't felt uncomfortable in this area.
Thank you. Christina Williams? Not here? Sorry, if you have something to speak to, can you speak to the clerk? Otherwise, I'd be bombarded with questions left and right. Thank you. Harris Brown? Alberto Avila? After Harris Brown.
Governor, I've been in a nightclub industry 18 years, I'm a promoter. And I've been around since Central Club and Central City, all the way to currently now at Playhouse. Some of them will be where you guys closed at, as well as Cosmo on the promotion side. Everything that these officers are pretty much saying happens, has happened from the 18 years of me being in nightclub industry. Every club I've ever worked at, whether it's an urban club or whether it's an EDM club, it's all the same. I've been to Cosmo, I've promoted at Cosmo, and I've never felt unsafe. I've never had, had a situation where I felt I was being murdered or killed.
Thank you. Alberto Avila.
Hi, my name is Alberto Avila, and I'm an owner to the Cosmo. And I'm trying to keep open my night job. I work hard to keep, to open this club. And I spend money for my life to make money to keep open and open this nightclub. And I don't know what happened. You guys all the time without complaints to my nightclub, and nobody contacted me. I'm leaving another, leaving Arizona, and the police department, nobody contacted me. We have my phone number. We have my address, and I don't receive phone calls. I don't receive nothing in the mail. So all the time, we need to ask my attorney who was around in my nightclub. Thank you.
Thank you. Moses Hill, Evan Barrett, and Conrad Stubberstock.
So, once again, my name is Moses Hill. I'm a campaign manager for Echoing Sounds. This is just a real clear case of discrimination, I'm not a racist advocate or an individual that complains about discrimination myself personally, but clearly based upon the investments that want to take place in Hollywood and you know, all the rhetoric that this particular venue has received, it's clear to me that they are being targeted along with the other seven clubs in Hollywood that have been shut down for similar reasons. I frequented Cosmo Nightclub, and I personally have never had any issues there. As a matter of fact, the operator of Cosmo Nightclub, he's one of the most serious and also strict venue operators in the city of Hollywood. So I really don't understand how any of this could be put on a particular venue. We're here today just to make sure that it's known that the public eye is very aware of what's going on in the city, and we're not willing to just sit by and listen to it silently. Thank you.
Thank you. Evan Garrett. Gentlemen, you with the garb on your head, otherwise known as Herman here in council chambers and every committee that ever happens in this building, if you keep walking up and down the aisle disturbing this meeting, I would ask you to please leave. This is your first warning. We have been advised by our city attorney that all we have to do is give you one warning, and the second time you will be asked to leave this meeting. Thank you very much. Your name is Evan Garrett?
Aaron Garrett.
Yes.
I am a bartender at Cosmo. I have been bartending for 10 years. I take my job very serious. I was cited for serving a beer to an overly intoxicated patron. To my knowledge, this never happened. It was alleged that the customer was stumbling. It was a slow night. I was helping one customer tops at a time. I have not, nor would I ever, serve somebody who was stumbling at my bar. I've been through star training. I take it very seriously. Actually, the ticket was never filed. I was never arrested. So, that's all.
Thank you. Conrad, Joseph Perez, and Brandon Sonberger.
My name is Conrad Straub. One thing the cops were saying was that there's all this crime attributed to do with Cosmo within the entire building area. There's 5-6 clubs there. There's restaurants. There's nothing else open but clubs, restaurants, and bars. So to say that we are the reason for all these violent crimes, assault, it's a pretty crazy that you can blame one particular business in an area with 6-7 surrounding businesses of the same nature. The cops say they come in and cite security guards. By our CEP, you only have to have 2 licensed security guards during the week and on the weekends. We can have upwards of 5 security guards or hosts as we will, but we only need to have 2 or 3. They'll go to the ones that aren't licensed and cite them, but we still do have our 2 to 3 guards per our CEP. And then on New Year's Eve, Cosmo was shut down by the police department, never issued a ticket, nothing, we have to arrest.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Joseph Perez, Jr., badge number 1087 from the State of California Department of Alcohol and Drug Control. The information I'm giving you is available on our website at www.abc.ca.gov. On September 10th, 2012, license number 48523702 was issued to Halloween Night Group, Inc. During this time, it's all on our website as well. They only have current disciplinary action under registration 160-84176. The count was pending accusation for an incident that happened on October 16, 2015. It's still ongoing. There is no further information available. If any questions, thank you.
Thank you very much. Brandon?
Good afternoon. My name is Brandon Songberger. I'm speaking on behalf of Sharna Halpern, who is the owner of IO West. We are the club right next door to Cosmo. We have been there for 14 years on the corner of Cosmo and Hollywood since they opened in 2013. In that summer, we noticed a market decrease in business caused primarily by the sound bleed that comes through their wall that makes it nearly impossible for us to have shows. It's a live comedy show. The addition of unwanted music has not been helpful. That, coupled with the violent activity that has resulted, has made it so we have lost a significant amount of profit in the time since they have been open. Thank you.
Thank you. Joel Green. Fonzel Harris. Joel Green. No. Fonzel Harris. Not here. Chris Robertson from Council District 13.
Good afternoon, Council Members. Chris Robertson, Planning Director for Council Member Mitchell Farrell of the 13th District. We're here this afternoon to express our strong support for the revocation of the conditional use permit for the Cosmo. As detailed earlier by Planning, LAPD, and in the letter that the Councilman submitted to the Planning Department, Cosmo has been cited for multiple and repeated violations of its CUP. The location has also been found on multiple occasions to be a source of criminal activity and other threats to public safety. Obtaining a CUP is a privilege and comes via an extensive public process and a commitment to comply with the terms of the permit. The recurring problems of this location violate the public trust and put a strain on city resources, including the Los Angeles Police Department, City Attorney, Department of Building and Safety, and Department of City Planning. Given the lengthy and well-documented history of conditional use violations of this establishment, as well as the other unlawful incidents, we respectfully ask that you uphold the zoning administrator's determination and deny the appeal. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? Okay. The record brought before us, I think, cites extensive incidents of where this establishment has violated several city codes and violated some of the conditions of their approvals. And I think the record speaks for itself, given also the testimony by our officers. So that's all I have to say at this time. Mr. Harris-Dawson?
Sure. No question for the zoning administrator. Documentation is fairly thorough and seems to cover a long period of time. I'm just curious from you, this is an area of work that I have a lot of experience with. I've never seen a situation where a business owner, and I've actually been a part of bringing cases where not only were they shooting, they were actually murders. Does the business owner, on the first go around, get a full revocation recommendation? Usually they get more security, more lights, more cameras, more less hours as a recommendation. I'm just curious about the length of time and the sort of ending up at this, what people refer to as a dead shot.
Well, at this point, it's discretionary, and if a business or an operation warrants, what we do, first of all, we have a public hearing for an imposition of conditions for a possible revocation of use. So we open it up and we review the evidence and the information that is before us to determine if it warrants going to a full revocation, but that's in the public hearing process after we weigh out the evidence. Now, plan approval, there were conditions that existed on the property in the 2013 case. However, and the zoning administrator does have the authority or to go back and open that case up and for as a plan approval and possible revocation action. But in this case, the evidence is overwhelming, as you can see in the documentation and the resources that have been pulled towards this location, where we wanted to open this up for a possible revocation, which we could not have done that under the 2013 case as a plan approval. And in this case, a plan approval, a position of conditions would have placed conditions on the operation for a period of, short period, maybe it's 6 months, 9 months, 12 months, or 2 years. But in this case, because of the information that was before us and the serious crimes that had occurred on the property and the multiple violations of existing conditions.
And I'm sorry, when you say serious crimes, can you say specifically what you mean?
I don't have the records in front of me. I think you have from the police reports. I think there were multiple assaults on the property that occurred between the time frame that I stated earlier. There was a stabbing or an assault. There was a there was fights. There was those are the type of criminal activities, and you have to refer to LAPD for more details on that because it is in the report. But that coupled with the violations of the 2013 CUP, the multiple violations and ongoing violations, and lack of correction of those violations, it was determined that we had enough evidence and enough documentation to open up a possible nuisance abatement revocation case.
Sure. So would you say it's typical for you for places that there are fights, stabbings, or shootings to come out with a recommendation for revocation on sort of at the first hearing?
I would say it's typical. I would say, again, it depends on the evidence and the location and what the violations actually are. But with this case, this is there really weren't any viable options. We didn't. A plan approval wouldn't have been appropriate. They were not abiding by the existing conditions that were already in place.
Right. But most businesses that get hearings are violating some part of the law, some part of the conditions that they have in businesses. So just as an example, you say no conditions were viable. Could you have said you have to close at midnight? Could you have said you have to have 5 security guards instead of 1? Could you have said you had to have a camera system that LAPD can tap into at all times? I mean, these are the typical kinds of conditions that I hear in cases that are frankly worse than this in terms of the severity of crime. I'm just trying to get and I looked through the police reports that you provided to us, and frankly, there were a lot of police reports, which I didn't know the police department would do. Police are doing citations because the company had flyers, which is definitely a violation of their parole, for sure. I just didn't know you could get a police officer to do that kind of documentation. Typically, you bring that up. In the stack of police reports, that I counted at least 6 times where actual LAPD officers on our city dime used time to document that a business had flyers. Which, again, clear violation of their conditions, but typically, again, I'll just say it outright. In my part time, we can't get police officers to do that, to spend their time on that. So I'm just curious about, was there a review camera system, more security, more lighting, changed hours? Was there anything other than you got to be out of business?
Well, in this case, again, looking at the evidence that I had before me and the frequency of the violations of conditions, it was my determination at that time, and because of the violent crimes that had occurred, the sexual assault, the fights and things that were going on the property and in the area, on the adjacent properties, it was my decision that additional conditions would not bring about the results that were necessary.
Thank you.
Thank you.